President Trump threatening to refuse to do his job and work with congressional Democrats in any way until Democrats stop conducting their oversight investigations into him and his presidency. Instead of talking with top Democrats about the potential $2 trillion deal to rebuild the nation's roads, bridges, broadband, electrical grid, and on, the president walked into this meeting at the White House, railed against the many investigations being waged by House Democrats into his administration, and then abruptly marched into the Rose Garden.
I told Senator Schumer, Speaker Pelosi, I want to do infrastructure. But you know what? You can't do it under these circumstances. So get these phony investigations over with.
Signs that this fit of pique was not as organic and impromptu as originally billed by the White House were evident in, well, a sign, specifically the pre-printed sign strategically placed in front of the podium containing familiar falsehoods about the Mueller investigation. I want to bring in CNN's Caitlin Collins now at the White House. And Caitlin, the White House claimed that the president's reaction was due to House Speaker Pelosi accusing him of engaging in a cover-up.
Yeah, they say it was that comment that she made this morning that upended that meeting for the ages that only lasted minutes today. And they're blaming her squarely for why these talks blew up. But Democrats say that they believe it's actually because the White House didn't have a plan for infrastructure in the first place.
The president's anger was obvious the minute he marched into the Rose Garden.
I walk in to look at people that had just said that I was doing a cover-up. I don't do cover-ups.
He had just blown up scheduled talks on infrastructure with Democrats after hours earlier the House Speaker accused him of hiding something.
We believe that the President of the United States is engaged in a cover-up.
Sources tell CNN Trump erupted when he heard Pelosi's claim, but told his aides not to cancel their meeting.
I came here to do a meeting.
Instead, sources said Trump entered the cabinet room without shaking a single Democrat's hand and lashed out at them as he declared he won't work with them until their investigations are over.
I told Senator Schumer, Speaker Pelosi, I want to do infrastructure. I want to do it more than you want to do it. But you know what? You can't do it under these circumstances. So get these phony investigations over with.
Democrats said they were shocked by the president's behavior.
To watch what happened in the White House would make your jaw drop.
But they voiced skepticism that this was all last minute.
It's clear that this was not a spontaneous move on the president's part. It was planned.
The Senate Minority Leader pointing to this sign printed and posted on the presidential lectern as proof that Trump staged the whole thing.
When we got in the room, the curtains were closed. And of course, then he went to the Rose Garden with prepared signs that had been printed up long before our meeting.
Pelosi suggested Trump used her comments as an excuse to get out of finding a way to pay for a $2 trillion infrastructure plan.
Hello, there were investigations going on 3 weeks ago when we met, and he still met with us.
Despite the showdown, Democrats say the investigations will go on.
This president is obstructing justice, and he's engaged in a cover-up, and that could be an impeachable offense.
Talks in Washington about impeachment have intensified in recent days and clearly rattled the president.
The I word. Can you imagine?
Today, the House Speaker left it at this.
I pray for the President of the United States, and I pray for the United States of America.
Now, Jake, the president said he refuses to work with Democrats until they stop investigating him, but it's unclear how sustainable that even is, because some of these investigations could take months, potentially even years, and of course, there are a slew of budget and funding deadlines that are approaching pretty quickly.
All right, Caitlin Collins, thanks so much. And let's talk about that right now with our experts. Sarah Murray, as Phil Mattingly pointed out, Capitol Hill folks are now trying to find out what this means. We have the U.S.-Mexico-Canada trade agreement, which the administration has called its legislative priority, which they need Democratic votes for. Budget caps, the debt ceiling, where some progress had been made yesterday. Disaster aid, Congress wanted to finish that this week. Is he just not going to sign anything? I mean, what does this mean exactly?
You know, the thing about being the president of the United States is you have to keep doing your job. So he may be very upset that these investigations are continuing and he's decided to sort of make this big statement. But I don't know what kind of reelection pitch it is to go into 2020 and say like, oh, you know, we just failed to extend the debt ceiling. We just failed to pass any budget bills. I just decided that I'm not going to do anything for the rest of my term because Democrats are investigating me, which, by the way, you know, a judge just said last week that Congress can investigate you. They're well within bounds to investigate you. Another judge is looking at that today. You know, I do think that this is going to set both sides up for an awkward standoff. We saw them play a game of chicken, the president and Nancy Pelosi, a previous round. So we may be in for another one of those. But I don't really know what kind of reelection pitch it is to just say, I'm not going to do my job anymore.
You worked in the George H.W. Bush White House. You worked for the vice president. You worked for Bill Clinton. I mean, as I recall, both of them were being investigated at multiple times by the opposite party controlling Congress, and you still did work, right? You still signed laws, and still, even if you didn't like the investigations.
Yeah, that was another country a long, long time ago.
That was back when America was great.
I mean, I don't know. You know, one thing that you mentioned the previous time they didn't succeed in getting to a deal, there was the shutdown. I think Trump thinks he didn't pay much of a price for that. And to be honest, do we think he did in terms of the long-term effect in the polls? He's not particularly strong. He's about where he was before the shutdown. And he may just think, you know what? He hasn't paid much of a price for all of his irresponsibility, all the things that people like me think you cannot do, you should not do if you're president of the United States. And he figures he'll test this out. He'll see if he can rally his troops. He'll see if some Democrats blink. Why not? It is mind-bogglingly both irresponsible and dishonest, as Chuck Schumer was saying. He had these signs printed out already.
Yeah.
I do love Infrastructure Week. I want to say every time they say it's going to be Infrastructure Week, we know there's going to be like something it's interesting amazing. Happening, right?
People are hurting, no. And a lot of people voted for Donald Trump are hurting. Right. Go! I mean, I don't know. I don't think we covered enough. The Upper Midwest is buried in water. It's flooding, like we haven't seen since 1993, and. They're hurting. And a lot of those people voted for Donald Trump. They're terrific people. They're good Americans. They pay their taxes. They need help.
Right.
And they need their president to work with their Congress to get them the help they need. This is not a game or a reality show, Mr. President. This is reality. And good people are suffering because of what you're threatening to do.
And Democrats have said, Laura, that one of the reasons they think this happened is because Mick Mulvaney, the White House chief of staff, hates the idea of any sort of $2 trillion infrastructure mm-hmm. deal. He doesn't want to spend that money, doesn't want to give the Democrats any sort of a victory, even if President Trump gets to share in it. So this was just a way to get out of it.
Yeah, that could be right. I mean, he's not the only one, right? Mitch McConnell, the leader of the Senate, doesn't want that either. And I'm pretty positive McCarthy doesn't want a $1 trillion deal on infrastructure as well, because as you mentioned, it would also be a win for Pelosi, not just the president. That being said, I did see some reports initially after their blow up non-existent meeting that some administration officials said that they still are going to try to work with Democrats on the budget caps and on the must-pass bills. Now, that's not infrastructure, and that's not, you know, other maybe deals that they want to pass, but on the budget caps and on spending deals, it looks like the president will still be talking to Democrats.
Was it a mistake, just to put yourself in the president's shoes, was it a mistake for Nancy Pelosi to accuse him of a cover-up, which is ramping up the rhetoric out of her mouth, not everybody's mouth, but out of her mouth, minutes before she goes to the White House?
I don't know if it was a mistake. I mean, if the president could have said, it's not true, and then he could have gone ahead, but you know what? I'm going to govern anyway. And that would have, I think, been rather effective politically. But again, I'm living in
an alternative
universe. 1980s or 1990s. I don't know.
The president does have the ability to do that when he wants to. You know, he's the kind of guy who could have looked at, you know, Nancy Pelosi and said, huh, you said some, like, very unfortunate things about me, but, like, let's go move this behind closed doors and hash out this infrastructure plan. But it's pretty clear that she gets under his skin and he reacts. And I think that's what we saw today.
And 3 weeks ago, they sat down. Pelosi, Schumer, and the president when Mick Mulvaney was out of town. Mm-hmm. And they had a good, productive meeting about infrastructure.
Right.
And it's not as though calls for the president's impeachment or investigations into him started today. They've been going on for months.
They have, but I think that the president probably noticed that there is a shift going on Capitol Hill right now. And there is. I mean, I've spoken to a number of members, and it's very noticeable the increase in the number of Democrats, and I'm not just talking far left progressives, but even some of the frontline members who are starting to say, oh, I think I may need to get on board with this impeachment inquiry, or we need to do something. We can't just be sitting here and watching as they stonewall everything. So I think that's why the president orchestrated this.